We're going to create a new screen. So under the Add Screen button, let's call this Context Screen. I'm going to go ahead and center the screen. So set the Align Horizontal to center. Let me add a couple of labels. And I'm also going to add an image, or not an image, I am going to add a web viewer. The first label is going to be the title or the name of the place, so I'm going to make that a little bit bigger, so let's do 24. And let's rename it organization label. And for now, I'm going to just erase that. It will get filled in when the screen opens. And the second label will be the phone number, so I'm going to call this phone label. And again, let's just leave that. Let's make that maybe 18. Okay, and then the web viewer will leave as is. Let's go back to screen one and see how we're going to jump from screen one to screen two by going to the blocks. So what we can do is if the user long clicks, so a regular click is going to pop up the info box. So we don't want that. So we're going to differentiate with the long click. So if they hold over a marker, we want to open the second screen. And so what we're going to do is go to control. And we want this open another screen with start value. And then if we grab a blank text box, the screen name is context screen, and the start value we want is going to be the name of the organization. And we want the full name because that's what's going to be displayed. So what I'm going to do is grab another text box, Greater Boston Food Bank. So what's going to happen is it's going to open context screen and it's going to pass this value over. It's almost like sending a message to the second screen. Let's do this for all four of our markers. So let's duplicate. So change this to Habitat for Humanity. Change the name here. And let's do that two more times. So this will be Maynard Food Pantry. Neighbors Who Care. Now let's go back to screen to the context screen. So what's going to happen is the context screen is going to receive the start value sent from screen one. So what we want to do in this screen is we want to display the name of the organization, the phone number, and display the web page. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make three lists to hold that information. So I'm going to call these names, and this is going to be a make a list. And there are four different organizations of mine, so I'm going to drag out two more items to make this a list of four. And the four are going to be my four names. So what I can do here is type in Greater Boston Food Bank. Very important is that we want to make sure that we've actually got the spelling exactly right. So we want to make sure back at screen one that we're using the exact same capitalization, etc. Because what we're going to do is use that information to figure out which organization we're talking about. So I'm just going to duplicate. And so this will be Maynard Food Bank, Habitat for Humanity, and finally Neighbors Who Care. I've got the names of the four organizations, and what I want to do is make a second list, and this will be the phone numbers. And this will also be a make a list with four items. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get my spreadsheet of my volunteer opportunities, and I have captured my phone number here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy each of these and put them into my phone number list and making sure that I've got them all in the same order. So Maynard should be next. Copy and paste this in. And we want to do that for all four of them. Last thing we're going to do is make a list for the websites. Again, list of four items. Text blocks, and we're going to go back to that same spreadsheet and grab the website. So we've got the information that we're going to display in these three different lists. So what we need to do is, go to the contact screen and find the contact screen initialize block. And what we're going to do is, when the screen opens, the initialize block is triggered. And we're going to look for that start value from screen one. And we're going to use that to figure out which item in the list we're looking at. So for instance, if I passed Habitat for Humanity, it would say, okay, that's the third item in the names list. So that means we want to pull out the third phone number and the third website. So what we need to do is find what's called the index into this list. And we can do that from the lists. And we need to say index and list thing. And the thing is from the control blocks get start value. So the thing that we're looking at is the start value that's passed from screen one. And the list that we're looking at is going to be names. Okay, so this will give us the index. So it'll be either 1, 2, 3, or 4 based on the start value. We need to save that information. So I'm going to make another variable, and I'm going to call it my index. And I'm going to just set it equal to 0 to start. But then what's going to happen is I'm going to set it in here to whatever the index in the list names is for the start value. So it's going to give me either a 1, 2, 3, or 4. And then I'm going to use that index to pull out the phone number and the website. What I'm going to do then is first say, let's set the organization text. So we want to set this equal to the name, which is in the names list. So I'm going to go to list, and I'm going to say select list item in the names list, and the index is going to be my variable index, right? So if I passed Habitat for Humanity as my start value, index would become 3. So I say set the organization label text to the third item in names, which again is Habitat for Humanity. So we're just displaying that. I'm also going to duplicate that and set the phone label to the select list item from phone numbers with the same index. So once I've got the index, I'm just going to reuse that over and over to get my information. The third thing is my web viewer. So the web viewer will display web pages. So what I want to do is I want to go to this URL. And the URL is going to be select list item websites index. Let's go ahead and try this. Okay, so let me go to Connect and the companion. I've got the companion running on my phone. And I'm going to get this error because I forgot to go back to screen one. So let's go back to screen one. We always have to start from screen one. So let me just show you what this looks like. So again, I have my four markers. And so say I pull down on the hammer, Habitat for Humanity. So it gives me Habitat for Humanity, the phone number for Habitat for Humanity, and then it displays the Habitat for Humanity website. So that works. Okay, now here's the one thing is I don't have a way to go back. So what I need to do is to actually go back to my contact screen designer, and I'm going to add a back button at the bottom. So go down to the bottom, and this will be my back button. And I'm going to say back. I might make that a little bit bigger. And then what's going to happen is when back button is clicked, I'm going to just close the screen. So this is a nice thing to understand is that when you open a screen, a second screen in App Inventor, it actually opens the screen on top of the screen that opened it. So screen one will be underneath context screen. If I then click the back button and I say close it, it's just going to remove the top screen. This is a much better way than opening screen one again, because what's going to happen is you're going to have a layer of several different screens, one on top of the other, and you're going to kind of clog up the memory of your app. So this is recommended if you're going back to the screen that you came from to just close the screen. Okay, so now that I have the back button, just go back and show you, I've got the back button. Now it will take me back to the screen one, and then let's say I can try Greater Boston Food Bank, and voila, that works as well. Now the other thing we're going to do on this is to allow the user to actually automatically call that. And because you can't actually click on a label, I'm going to replace that with a button. So let me again go back to the designer. I just want to put something in there so I can see it. I am going to add a button in there below it. And this is going to be my phone button. And I'll just put in phone here. For now, again, maybe let's make this a little bit bigger. And let's go back to blocks. And instead of the phone label, let's set the phone button text to this. And then I can get rid of this. And I'll go back to the designer and I'll actually get rid of the phone label. So I'll delete that. Let me go back to screen one. And let's go back here, and if I say Habitat for Humanity, I can now click on this button, and let's have it automatically call in the app. To do that, once again, let's go to the designer, and under social, let's add a phone call in there. Phone call is a non-visible component that allows you to make phone calls. So if we go back to blocks, let's say if I click on the phone button, what I want to do is set the phone call number to the number that appears on the phone button text. So whatever's on the phone button, I'm going to set the phone number for the phone call component to that, and then I'm going to say make a phone call. So now just to see how that will look, if I were to click on this, it's going to come up in my phone app on my phone and allow me to go ahead and press the green button and call them. I don't want to do that right now, so I'll come back. Okay, now if I hit back here, this will take me again back. So this should work for all of them. Let me just try one more. So let's try our Neighbors Who Care. I'll click on the button, and it's going to try to make that phone call. So there you go. We have a pretty cool app that, number one, allows you to view different volunteer opportunities in your area. It gives you a little bit of information when you click on them. And then if you long click, it gives you access to the phone number and the website and gives you more information and the ability to call them up and volunteer your services. So well done. Very quickly, we put together a pretty substantial app, and there's plenty more you could add to it. You could add a lot more details and information for people who are looking for volunteer opportunities. So see what you can make out of this.